Hey guys, my name is Colin. If you're a first-time snake owner, your snake, its first shed, it's going to be a pretty big deal to you. You've never dealt with this before, and so you don't really know what's going on. So in this video, I'm just going to explain what's happening with your snake so you just are more educated. Welcome to Classy Herbs. Alright, so you're wondering what it means to shed your skin. Well, snakes are obviously, their skin is different from a human's. They have an outer layer of skin, or an epidural type skin, instead of humans. Our skin stretches out with us as we grow. Theirs is not. From the millions of years of evolution they've lived, they've formed these plates of skin you can see there, and this is great for protection as they're very hard, but it does have its downside, is that it does not grow with the snake. So when the snake keeps growing and growing and it stretches to its max, then it can't stretch anymore. And how does it grow? Well, it sheds off that outer layer of skin and just grows in a new one. Now, snake is always in its shed cycle from start to beginning. They start right after they get the one before off. Alright, now this snake right now is not currently in shed, but it's eating right now, and as it's going to continue to eat, it's going to kind of move into a phase like this. This is the next step of shedding. You can see this animal here is what we refer to as in blue. It's where its skin has turned kind of a bluish gray color. You can see its eyes here, obviously, are extremely blue there. It looks like wax paper is covering their eyes, and their colors, their pigment has gone away pretty much completely. These are both normals here, and you can see the difference, how pale she is really. Another sign of shedding skin is their stomachs are gonna go into like a pinkish color instead of from just a white. You can see it's kind of a pinkish color. Alright, so why do they form this milkish looking bluish color right before they're gonna shed? Well, the answer is their body forms this milky secretion that is just between this old layer of skin on the outside and the new layer on the inside. Now, they're forming that to kind of lubricate themselves so it can come off easy. Now, right before they shed, that lubricant is going to be absorbed into the old layer of skin, and that's just going to help it slide right off and help it all come off in one piece. When that gets absorbed, they're going to look completely normal, and it's going to take about a day, maybe two, maybe three, depending on your humidity levels, but they're going to look completely normal after 3 days to a week of looking like being in blue here, and they're going to look completely normal. And then pretty shortly after their skin has absorbed that milky substance, they're going to crawl right out of their skin, and it's just going to come right off. Now, while your snake is in this blue phase, it's really important to increase their humidity to more lubricate their skin to get it to come off easy. So, what a good thing you want to do is basically just spray the cage down. Now, a tip, you can always, if you just have one, just go with the normal spray bottle that you can get, you know. But when you're going through a lot of cages like I have to do, and a lot of them like to go into shed at the same time it seems, get one of these big lawn sprayers that you would probably spray chemicals on with, but just give it a few pumps, fill it with water, make sure it's clean, and then just spray the snake down really good. Spray the animal down, and you can just see the water forming on them, and spray it on their bedding really good. That's super important. If your animal has a dry cage when it's shedding, then a lot of things could happen. Mainly, the skin is just going to stay stuck onto the snake, and that's really bad. It'll only come off in chunks. It's all ripped in pieces. It's really bad for the animal. It's really unhealthy for it. One thing you can do is give it a soak in a bath of about an inch of warm water, and for about an hour, just let it soak, and that skin is just going to slough off real easy. It's just going to slide right off. Pieces of skin will be in there, and your animal will hopefully be healthy. Another big thing where skin can get stuck on the animal is on the eye caps. I have never actually had it happen before, but I do know how to treat it. Get one of the little rubber finger and just very gently rub it over your snake's eyes. Make sure the eye caps are really important. Some stuck shed on the body is okay. It'll probably come off next time if you take better precautions and keep the humidity up, but an eye cap will prevent it from seeing, and it'll be really frightened. It might bite you because it doesn't know what's happening, and it probably won't eat because it can't see what it's going to eat. So you're gonna have a lot of problems if you get eye caps stuck. So just to avoid everything, just when it goes into shed, just spray the cage down really well. Here's a freshly shed snake. She probably shed up just a few days ago. This is a normal, but you can see just how vibrant their colors are right when they get finished, because that new layer of skin hasn't really had time to really harden up yet to be ready for the elements, so it's really soft still. You might want to be careful when you're handling them just after shedding, but they're going to be their most just absolutely beautiful right after they shed. You can see this girl is just amazing. This one here is also just shed. You can just see her yellow is just absolutely glowing beautiful. Here's another example of a ball python in shed. It's my pie ball. You can see her eyes just absolutely blue as can be. And she's beginning to soak up her that secretion. And so she's beginning to get a little bit of color back, so within the next week she will be shed. Now in the end you're going to end up with a really cool souvenir if your snake sheds right. It'll shed in one big piece, and sometimes you even get the head out perfectly. Yeah, you can see this is my girl Carmen's recent shed of her. This is Henry, the green tree python's compared. And you know, I've never been able to measure him obviously because he's always curled up and will always bite me. But shedding is always a good way to tell how long your snake is, because they're always, you can stretch it out and you can measure it. Another thing, when a snake sheds, it's not going to eat, most likely. Yeah, they don't know what they're eating at, and they're going through a time of just preparing to get that skin off, so they're probably not going to eat. Something that I've just noticed, I don't know if anyone else has, but when snakes are young, like really young, probably anywhere under like 5 months old, they do tend to have problems shedding completely in one piece, even no matter how high you make the humidity. I've noticed that just from personal experience. So don't worry if you have a really young snake and it's not shedding correctly, because a lot of the times it's just they're young and something in their bodies, they're just not ready yet. But when they get older, about 6 months or so, it's really rare actually, if you have your humidity correct, to see a snake not shed not one piece. Now the whole process, depending on your humidity and age level of the animal, probably take about a week or so to complete from when they go into blue to shedding. But remember, they're always beginning to work on their next layer of skin. Some general things to remember is, remember, when your snake is in shed, it can't see what's going on and they typically get more aggressive. As you can see, this girl here wouldn't hesitate to bite me, even though when she's normal, she probably wouldn't. Now you're wondering, how often does a snake shed its skin? Well, the answer is it depends on how much it's eating and how old it is. A young snake is going to shed its skin maybe 2 to 3 times more than an adult, because they're growing. And that's the reason, remember, snakes shed their skin, because they're growing. So a young snake like this might shed every month or two, while an older snake might only shed every 2 months or so. They really only shed their skin as adults because they need a new layer of skin because it's been damaged. They don't need it because they're growing, because if they're adults, they're done growing. And it takes about a week to shed their skin from going into blue to actually shedding. So overall, a snake might shed its skin 4 to 8 times in a year. And remember, shedding is a good thing because it is an indicator of only that your snake is growing and you're feeding it and it's healthy. Hey guys, I'm here with your pup of the week. This week it's a real cutie. It's a little boy. You see, he's black and white with just a little white spot right there on his nose. He's really cute. He's got a whole full black stripe going down him there. That has been your pup of the week.
It's time for the weekly comment contest.
So this year's babies are starting to hatch. We want to know if you prefer buying online or in person. Why? Please leave your comment down below for a shout out next Monday. Last week's comic contest question, which was, what do you have planned for the future, was best answered by JMZ Reptiles, who said, I'll be getting 6 albino and head albino red tails in a few months. Until then, I'll be getting a pastel male, a spider female, and 2 yellow bellies. I might get some more gopher snakes if I see any at the Tampa Expo I'm going to. Good luck with those 6 red tails you're getting. They sound like a handful. See you guys next Monday. Bye. Cut!